celebs can be thrifty when they want to be, like Cardi B's recent $25 lip piercing. Huh. But as we know, more often than not, they spend as much cash as possible. Which brings us to February's sixth list of rich. All right, so let's get started with number six on the list. Naomi Campbell's $4,000 puffy coat.
Ooh.
Yes, she was spotted leaving London's Heathrow Airport in this coat from Moncler's fall 2018 collection.
Honestly, I'm very envious of this because winter coats are expensive, and as a girl from LA, I have not yet pulled out the big bucks for a real winter coat in New York.
Well,
I feel like you're gonna kick a lot of stuff up, though. It's full length. Who ever heard of a full length? It's like a gown.
That's true. It'll drag in the snow.
Yeah,
drag in the snow.
Okay. It's filthy.
Moving on to number five on our sixth list of rich, Kylie Jenner's $10,000 towels. Kylie's on the cover of the latest issue of Architectural Digest, and eagle-eye readers noticed she had 16 Louis Vuitton monogram beach towels in her bathroom. They cost $590 each. Okay, now Kylie also posts pics and videos of her latest Louis Vuitton obsession, slippers. Now each pair of slippers is $2,000.
Stop it! Okay, I'm just glad, I wanted to make sure they weren't white towels because with the amount of makeup contouring she does, it'd be filthy every day. She'd need 15. And I love that people are counting how many towels.
That would be good branding though.
Right, it would be. Good for the, okay. Moving on to number four, Russell Wilson and Sierra, the NFL quarterback, posted this boudoir shot with his wife for Valentine's Day, va-va-voom. And then followed it up by revealing that he and Sierra were now the owners of matching Mercedes G-Wagon, oh my God, SUVs. Those start at $125,000 each.
Okay, so this might be an unpopular opinion, and obviously it's very expensive and very nice, but I just think the G-Wagon is the ugliest car on
really?
The road.
Really? I don't hate it.
Not
I don't hate it.
That is an unpopular opinion.
I know. I love Mercedes, but I don't like that one. It's just...
That's a cargo. I like something with a lot of cargo room, but like, so what if you have matching ones? You're not driving side by side.
Good point. Good point. Coming in at number three on our list is Drake. He's known for rich purchases, but this $400,000 iPhone case might be his most outrageous yet. Now, it's made of 18-karat white gold, and it's entirely studded with small blue diamonds. The tech jewelry is finished off with a white gold OVO owl logo in the center with two big diamond eyes, of course.
That's a $500,000 phone case.
Makes
no sense. All right, so moving on to number two on our list, which is even richer. Gucci Mane and Keisha Kaur love rich things. And Keisha just gave her husband a 35-carat diamond pinky ring for his 39th birthday. Now that ring is worth over $1 million.
Stop it. And it's not even big enough for a big finger. It's just the pinky. Okay. I don't think anyone's gonna be able to top Gucci Mane, except for number one on our list, Gucci Mane.
Oh.
Yes. He just gave Keisha a 60-carat upgrade engagement. Not 60. 60 carat. Sorry, Jay-Z. That's way bigger than Beyonce's $5 million 18-carat ring. It's even bigger than Elizabeth Taylor's iconic $8.8 million 33-carat ring. This rock is even bigger than Mariah Carey's $10 million 35-carat ridiculous ring from James Packer. This is a very rich ring. I think you can get scoliosis just hanging this ring on one arm.
Prince fans, unite. Yes, this one is for you. Well, if you live in Seattle, right? So a new exhibit that's dedicated to Prince is gonna be at Seattle's MoPOP Museum. It's debuting on April 6th. Now, this is a pretty big exhibit. Now, we're talking photographers who shot the late icon in his earlier careers. It's gonna display almost 50 artifacts, including photos, artwork, and one of Prince's guitars and outfits from the Purple Rain tour. Yes.
That sounds amazing.
Hi, Jeremy. I am visiting you in Seattle. That's the only person
right.
I know in Seattle.
I love
but
it.
But no, I'm super excited about this. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, very cool. Okay, it's also that time of the week when we shout out celebs doing good. That's right, it's time for Way to Go Wednesday. All right, Elizabeth, who you got?
Okay, so today I am shouting out Regina King.
Yeah.
And this is really a crazy story. Okay, so Gabrielle Union said that Regina King literally saved her life. And I'm not using the word literally, just to use it. Like, she actually saved her life. So in 2007, they went on a snorkeling trip and she almost drowned in a riptide. So Gabrielle Union and Regina King, they were in Bermuda after hosting the Black Girls Rock Show. And this is what Gabrielle Union said, quote, "We were snorkeling and being badasses and we snorkeled out to an area that we probably shouldn't have been in and then the current got us." Well, Regina King has also spoken about this story and she said that aside from the current current in the riptide that there was a jellyfish, and that freaked out Gabrielle Union. Oh. So Regina King saw it, and she jumped off a rock to go save her. But now, I love what Regina King said about it. She kind of patted herself on the back. She joked, if it were another actress, they wouldn't have saved her because that would have been a job opening.
Right.
It's been almost a week since Amazon bailed on their plans for new headquarters here in New York, and now we know why. It's all the fault of Carlos's sources and spies. Carlos, you have some explaining to do.
All right, so as we know, Amazon was supposed to be coming to New York City, one of their headquarters. They pulled out, and sources are telling us, and one of the reasons they pulled out, it may be because there's an upside to Jeff Bezos' personal life. As we know, since we've reported that he and Lauren Sanchez are dating and he's getting a divorce from his wife, he's been in the media. He's been in the gossip pages of Page Six.
You think he has?
He has. I mean, hello, he's the richest man in the world. It's gossip page gold, and he's dating Lauren Sanchez and getting a divorce. Gossip page gold. But here's the thing. New York City and L.A. are two very different places, so he's under the microscope. It's very different from living in Seattle. And you guys remember when Lauren Sanchez, the one sighting that we've had, we do have of her in New York City since they've announced that they were together. Sources called us. They told us that she was in a restaurant on the Upper East Side. She walked in with this air of, I've arrived. So he wants to avoid headlines like that.
I mean, yeah, I mean, obviously, all eyes are going to be on either one of them at all times now. And I think it doesn't really matter where they are. But yes, New York and L.A. would certainly illuminate
Yeah,
them.
But I don't think Lauren's going to mind that so much.
No, no, she seems
okay
like she
it.
Likes
I agree with you, Brian.
Yeah, no, she loves the spotlight for sure. But, you know, if the deal did go through, he would have to be in New York City at least twice a week. But I will say this. Another source told us that the decision had nothing to do with his personal life being under the microscope. In fact, they said Amazon has been scrutinized by the media. It's an entire his entire business life, but that's different than reporting about his relationship with Lauren Sanchez. Yeah. Kenan Thompson is Saturday Night Live's longest running cast member, and now he's busier than ever. And I'm talking super busy. It was recently announced that Kenan is bringing back the kids' comedy sketch, All That. Remember Nickelodeon in the 90s? That's how a lot of us were introduced to Kenan Thompson. Yes. I loved that show growing up. But, you know, it's the show that made him famous. We actually caught up with him at the Writers Guild Awards, and he told us that another famous cast member, Kel Mitchell, you know, they were really good friends, and they were one of the
Kenan and Kel.
Two of the biggest stars on that show at the time. Like you mentioned, Kenan and Kel. Who can forget Good Burger? Remember the movie in the 90s that came out of that?
Anyway, Kenan.
But, you know, so they also starred in Good Burger, as I mentioned. That was a 90s favorite for a lot of folks. Remember Carmen Electra in that movie, too, that one scene, taking it back. But so we caught up with him. Now, Amanda Bynes also got her start on that comedy show. A lot of people were introduced to her. No word yet if she's going to be a part of this reboot.
Well, but they're all invited, right? Are they all welcome to?
They're all welcome. The other cast members are wanting to come back.
Well, you know, Nick Cannon, he also got his start on All That. It really brought out a lot of current comedy stars. But Nick Cannon and Kenan Thompson, they are still very good friends. In fact, they actually used to be roommates back in the day. So no word yet if he will be back, but I would not be surprised.
Well, I just want TLC to come back. My favorite group of all time. You know, they did the theme song, All That. Can't sing it for you.
Yeah, we can't sing
Still don't have a voice, so I can't sing it for you. But I really want, I hope they come back and redo the theme song.